episode of 28th and Jefferson podcast. Today, you have Candy Coated AB in the building. We have
J-Dub in the building.
J-Dub, as always. And we have our special guest, CKDO. How you doing today?
I'm doing all right.
Well, we have Reggie from CKDO. Yeah. How are you today?
Feeling pretty good.
Good. We appreciate you being on the show today, and we appreciate you giving us the opportunity to interview you, find out what you got going on next, and tell us about some things you've had going on in the past. So, Doug, you want to start?
So, let's start them off, CKDO. They know, around the city, the clothing brand, we're talking about 2009, established and got going. Tell them about CKDO, man. What did this come about?
Okay, so it's kind of started when I was in college. I went to Alabama A&M. So, 2009, I'm kind of thinking, like, I don't really want to be here.
They said it's popping on
there. I mean, it's cool. Like, the coach and everything, like, that was cool. But when it comes to, like, just sitting in the class, you don't really want to be there. So, it's like, man, I'm here physically, mentally.
Mentally,
so I'm like, I'm not here. So, I felt like a dropout in my mind.
Well, what'd you decide to do from there? You got this brilliant idea? Did that what started off? Was it you or the people? What sparked it for you?
Going to LA. And like, just kind of like the internet, just being on the internet 24/7, streetwear culture. When I there, it just kind of made sense to like, you know, this is what I want to do. I went for spring break. And then after that, I was going to like H3C Festival, like early South by Southwest. Like in 2008, 9, 10, I was going real early. And I kind of knew what I wanted to do.
So, okay, so what does CKDO stand for?
College Kids and Dropouts. I kind of hate it.
College Kids name, you know? And Dropouts. That's real powerful when you think about it. Because, you know, you got a lot of college kids, you got a lot of college dropouts. Mm-hmm. And a lot of people have, you know, the same experience with college that you did. Like, they'll get in there and be like, man. That was me. I was in there like, I'm wasting so much fucking money. I'm just sitting in here like,
exactly.
I'm in the classroom, but I'm doing dance moves in my head. You know, I'm like, I need to be somewhere else. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So I'm wasting money every day. So like, so many people can relate to that. Mm-hmm. You know, do you have a lot of supporters when it comes to your brand?
I do. I got a good core following. Like, there's a lot of people been rocking with me for like a long time, and I appreciate that. You know, you get new people, and it's dope.
As far as brand ambassadoring goes, like brand ambassadors, like how do you, you know, recruit people to rock your gear? Or do people like come to you and ask you about it? Or you see someone that has like a big following and then, you know, reach out to them? How does that work?
Man, it kind of just come my way or come our way from whether if we're doing pop-up shops, Trend Friday, that kind of always helps our brand kind of grow locally. But when we travel and we represent, that always gets new followers, which is dope.
Dope.
Okay. So with that, what has brought on the clothing line into Trap Friday? Because I done been to a few Trap Fridays, and I remember going one time, they got some violence, some things transpired, and then another time it was just so chill, and everybody was vibed out, and it still kept going. I was in beginning stages, and then it grew to people just coming out, celebrating. It was festive. It was birthday, graduation. You come to Trap Friday. Then it was just, man, if you had nothing else to do on Friday, you better make sure you was at Trap Friday. So it's been years of Trap Friday, man. So what, from the clothing brand line, what expanded that to, we got a whole event series. What brought that about?
Like, how did they tie into each other?
It was me and the homies chilling. We just at the crib, kicking it, homegirls. Then we want to go to the club and they don't let us in. So it's just kind of like,
damn. They mad about them sneakers, they be turning about t-shirt, hats, came with no fitted and
exactly.
You know what I mean? So we was just like,
the dress code.
We just going to create something. Honestly, the name Trap Friday, we just like, it just sounded cool. And we just stuck with it and we just did it at the crib. And there was this dude named Alizano. I don't know if y'all know him, but he managed a few artists. He's a cool dude. He just let us kind of trap his house out. That's how it started. He kind of showed us the way. Him and Love Noise.
Okay.
Shout out to Love Noise. And Al. Shout out. Okay. So, with that being said, as far as CKDO, you know, of course, college kids and dropouts. Not only college kids and dropouts can only wear your gear, mm-hmm. but do you have, you know, people who have never attended college or, you know, aren't even in college yet, they want, like, to wear your gear? Do you like a lot of people like that?
Yeah, I kind of like that it kind of, like, everybody wants to be a part of mm-hmm. it. That they might not even went to school, but they kind of know, because at the end of the day, even if you didn't like attend school, mm-hmm. you know somebody that either went to school or dropped out.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So everybody can relate to it.
And when was CKDO established? Like, how did it come about? What year?
No, 09. I was probably like 2021. No, 20. Yeah, I was 21. I already now, but it was just like, yeah, this is what I want to do. And it was a blog first, so I was just posting artists, you know, people that rap and mm-hmm. stuff like that, and just traveling. And I got a lot of, you know, stuff on my computer with just blog material, getting shout outs, people rapping CKDO.
Yeah.
That's dope. Mm-hmm.
So from there, like, we're in now 2018. What's next? What's coming up with? Don't tell everybody.
Don't tell you secrets, but give us
you
something to look forward to.
You all still moving in the city.
Yeah.
Still the brand. Still the name. Got on my homie, Young Zach on there. Young Walt on there.
Yeah.
Shout out to Walt.
Everybody working hard.
Yeah.
For the CKDO brand.
What's next for CKDO? I don't know how much longer Trap Riders is gonna keep on going.
Why not?
I think we might move into like another direction with that.
Okay.
As far as like demographics and age groups?
Demographics, we might go younger. You know what I mean? Because the older you get, people get married and they're not going to the club. You know what I'm saying? Like,
but think about it, you might want to go the older, you know what I mean? And kind of mature and spice it up, because these days, the club scene, the, you know, out scene, whatever you want to call it, they're getting rowdy. So, mm-hmm. not saying, you know, it's a lot more, less balanced the older you go. Mm-hmm. So you might want to mature CKDO.
Yeah, that's
true.
You
know what I mean? You might want to reach out to that age group and do something real formal. You never know.
I don't know if it'll go formal though.
You don't know if you would. I mean, you could still, you know,
we might do something where it's just like fully dedicated to the ladies.
You know, I'm always all for that.
See?
Ladies I'm always all for that.
Ladies
me
first.
Know.
You know? What's next? So we got a lot of like stuff going on. We got Walt, he's DJing.
Mm-hmm. Then he just do like, he did a set, like his first DJing set was like this year. Like, yeah. I was out of town, but I heard about him.
Shout out to Delisha.
Oh, shout out to Delisha. We love her.
Two on the cloud. She invited Walt to DJ at one of her last events
mm-hmm.
that she was a part of. That was Walt's first time DJing.
I know he should.
And for her to reach out, she like,
I know he should.
She got to have the best of the best. Yeah. So for she had to really have some eyes on him. Like, hey, I'm gonna give you this chance. Don't fuck it up.
Yeah, he's serious about it.
Yeah.
And man, me and it's funny when I think about it. Me and Mike Floss. You know Mike Floss?
Oh yeah.
You know, I don't.
Oh
know
yeah. Mike. You don't know Mike Floss?
No, I don't.
I'm gonna have to get you on the Jimmy Wave.
Mike is cold, man. Like,
shout out Mike
Flowers. Man, shout out, man. He
we need
like,
to meet Jimmy Wave.
Like, he produces, he does all this, like, you know, he travels, he gets to perform in front of a large crowd. Man, me and him got like 30 songs, like 30 or 40 songs. It's crazy, because I don't really think myself as a rapper, but.
It's a hobby.
Yeah, I'm just
more than a career.
Yeah.
And we have people out here like that. Everybody doesn't have to like,
passion out
you know, be looking for a career, and it's just something that they love to do as like an outlet. Mm-hmm. I can totally get it. I understand.
Just create. This is another way to create. Yeah. You know. And more clothes, more experiences with like the clothing, CKDO, and more art projects, more content, media, mm-hmm. images, kind of restructuring.
Yeah, you gotta do that when, you know, years come about. You gotta figure out how to restructure, resurface, and still be successful within your business.
Mm-hmm.
Because it's different people, times change, and like, you know, needs and wants as far as, you know, clothing, seasonal clothing, whatever, you know, they change. So you have to adjust to what people are then rocking or then looking for or then interested in. Not saying that you gotta change up what you're doing. You just have to find a different way to, or a different avenue to spin it. And still make it, lucrative. You know what I mean?
Always good to do.
Yeah, I feel it.
Yeah.
So what else on your mind, man? We see what, it's all about you.
What you listening to?
What am I listening to?
What you listening to? Who are you listening to?
Right now, when I pulled up, I was listening to Hit-Boy, Tony Fontana, his new type, Dom Kennedy.
Dom Kennedy?
Half a Meal, him and Hit-Boy.
I'm gonna go listen to
that. And what's this last tape he dropped?
Dom?
Los Angeles Isn't For Sale. Fat Man Key.
I need to
Shout out Fat Man Key.
I can't really think of it anymore.
You give me like a LA vibe, like, you know, I don't know if it's that West Coast vibe. Like, where you from?
Antioch.
But you give it to me though all day. Like he gives me that West Coast vibe, that laid back, that yes, whatever, I'm cool, calm and collected, but don't cross me, I'll fuck you up. You know, he gives me that all day long. So that's pretty dope. Okay.
Yeah.
Well, dope. That's, shit.
Yeah, that's about like, I kind of like to listen to like artists that really got something to say. You know, I can kind of feel them. There's a lot of going on. It's a lot of stuff going on these days.
Exactly.
Are you planning out for it, or?
Man, I want to give, even with the lane that we're going in, I kind of want to do things where we kind of focus on putting like some workshops together. Creating, giving kids like knowledge on, you know, whether how to start their brand or what to do after they get out of college. And,
that's a dope idea.
You know, teach them how to market things, teach them how to create, like what we're doing here. This is kind of get people out the streets. It's cool.
Absolutely. We all need several outlets for these kids right about
things
now.
Things like that.
Because they don't have the options like we used to have.
Exactly. So. And academically, and like the activities that they have in school are no longer serving as positive outlets. I mean, it's something to do after school. Yeah, I'm on the majorette team or I play the drums and the band, but
they cut band funding.
They're cutting everything these days, and the kids are suffering.
Kids in our Middle Tennessee area need some ideas. They need some creativity.
Sure.
Need some guidance.
I think stuff like this is dope, man. Appreciate y'all for like posting all, you know, the flyers and stuff like that.
Oh yeah.
Shout out to Mad CTV.
The more people that I can see this TV, the better we all gonna be.
Exactly.
The whole community is gonna be involved.
But that's what Mad CTV is built off. You know, they like Mad CTV supports. They see people doing dope people doing dope things around the city, not only in Nashville, but just period. And you know, they actually bring like a platform and recognize you for that. You know, so for you to be posted, you know, they like you. You're doing something.
As y'all know, like, you know, I kind of switched why I kind of moved, like, the Instagram and everything around to my personal page. Giving CKDO is like its own page and its own company and own lane instead of me being tagged to it, so I can kind of move more and do things, you know what I mean, and not have to always think about like how it's gonna kind of bother CKDO. I can just kind of be myself.
Exactly.
Keeping it personal, and then it's over there.
Yeah, people don't tag what you're doing to your business. Your business doesn't suffer. Not saying necessarily that your business will suffer, because as you all know, if you follow me, I do what I want. I do what I want to do, and my business is my business, you know. Everything, you know, I won't post anything that I think is, like, detrimental to my business or detrimental to my following or, you know, people, you know, hiring me for this or that gig. But, you know, you got to be yourself. You have to have a platform to be able to do that. And that's why when a lot of people that work for themselves and entrepreneurs, they work for themselves, they get that. You know, you can't worry about, is this Susie from my job trying to follow me? Uh-uh, girl, I ain't posting me smoking no blunt. Susie from my job trying to follow me. I gotta go to work in the morning. I cannot take these shots. You know? No, fuck Susie.
Susie is a liar.
Fuck Susie. Like that's what that's what you get for being an entrepreneur. You get that. You know what I mean? So I understand what you're saying because some people might look at you and be like, the business that he got going on, I love you, but I don't like how he represents it.
Exactly.
And they got to learn how to separate the two. I have a business page and I have a personal page, but I also post my business on my personal as well. Right. You know, you going to support it or you're not. What is it?
Yeah, that's my approach now. It's almost like you looking at it like if I play ball for like Chicago Bulls, but I'm sponsored for Nike. You get me? It's like Michael Jordan playing for the Bulls. That's his job.
Mm-hmm.
But then Michael Jordan go.
Nike want to get the check from.
Get a Nike check. You go get a Gatorade check.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? You know, it's not like you don't think about him just on the Bulls team. So he
right.
can come. His name is not.
He has an endorsement.
It's separated from like who he is.
Mm-hmm.
I think I explained that.
You explained it.
Perfect way to do it. So if you're watching, you listening. Just explain to you. Separate your business from your person. It gives you freedom.
That was a free game. That was a free game.
It's, and like, I don't know if y'all are familiar with like Virgil Abloh. He's the new director of like Louis Vuitton. So brand is Off-White. So if he has a brand but now he's over at Louis Vuitton. His brand doesn't die, but he's able to move. He's his own identity.
Right.
He just created something.
That was free game we just gave y'all.
Out of his own.
Are we going to get any of your music?
Huh?
Are we going to get to hear any of your music?
Man.
Are we going to get to hear any of your music?
What is that thing?
Man, I think I could let y'all hear something. It'll probably be on the SoundCloud or iTunes.
Okay, you got to give people your social media tag so they know how to go find it.
Man, it's probably everything that's going to drop is going to drop probably on Sounds by CKDO.
Mm-hmm.
That was
Sounds.
That's
that was the Trap Friday page, it sounds by CKDO. And probably my personal page. Like I'm gonna be putting content out with the music and you know, hopefully it catch some people's ears. We're not really talking about too much, but
you gotta do it. He said we're not talking, we gotta do it. That's the way he said, yeah.
we're going out to eat, we kicking it with the homies, pulling up with the girls.
He said homegirls, so he ain't bringing sand to the beach. He said, we pulling up with the homegirls. You know, this ain't my chick. It's just the homie.
I think the city can need some of that. You know what I mean?
It's real peaceful vibes. Music.
You know what I mean?
Okay.
Some real vibes. Man.
You gonna give us some West Coast swag?
Nah.
Oh, some Antioch swag.
Straight Antioch.
Antioch strong.
I got a question. Okay, and I always thought this about Antioch because it seems like y'all got a lot of hustler spirit out there.
Mm-hmm.
What is it about Antioch that makes the hustlers, the people that go out and try to, you know, entrepreneurs like yourself?
Yeah.
What is it about Antioch specifically?
I don't know, man. It could be that we was birthed around a lot of cool stuff. We had fat caps, and as much as I can remember, we was the place throwing all the parties.
Especially the house parties, though.
The house parties
and the set started out over there.
You know what I mean? Like,
now they call them kickbacks.
Exactly. But that was out this shit. Way.
And the data was set.
We had Fat Caps, Hickory Hollow Mom.
Hickory Hollow Mom, boy.
You know what I mean? And then you can go to the party, like a house party at the Days In, you know.
Days
no,
In, right on
man,
Bill
those
Road. Okay.
Right there were the shit.
Come on, man. Hotel bar, like, so I can't, like, you gotta
right
be.
Right there by Snooker.
We was already creative. We was in, like, the whole mix. A lot of people was coming from elsewhere.
Coming
to
India.
Yeah. Like, I thought it was in Nashville. No, we're about 20 minutes on the highway. When we get there,
we gonna let
I
you know.
I think that's what that is, you know.
Yeah, he's right. I agree with that.
Antioch strong.
You from Nashville, you've been in Antioch.
Oh yeah. You know have some plenty of stories. Plenty of stories in the yacht.
What's your
name? I'm keeping mine to myself.
So
okay, I got a question.
Uh-huh.
So a lot of your merch, you know, it's not seasonal. So you can wear it any time of the year, any, you know, place, any temp, whatever. Mm-hmm. Have you ever thought about doing like a fit, like a, not fitness line, but something that people can wear, you know, anywhere, anytime, as far as like, you know, in Miami it stays hot, in Cali it stays hot, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
You got your sweatshirts, you got your hoodies, but what about, you know, somebody could just throw in a tank and I could go, you know, run it.
You know what, it's crazy.
Or some towels, you know, like some sweat towels and stuff like that.
Oh, that's dope, that's dope. I, you know, I definitely want to do some towels. I thought about that. Just, you know, we got a lot more work to do. Mm-hmm. We had some stuff for the ladies.
Okay, wait.
It was, we did it last year. Mm-hmm. And my homegirl, Whitney, she had put it together. I don't know if y'all know Whitney.
What's up, Whitney?
Shout out Whitney.
She kind of cool, man. She cool. But she had did, like, she had a project with us, and it was like, we had the girls, like, leggings and workout clothes and stuff like that.
See, now that's what we talked about before the show.
It sold out, though.
Look with me.
I told you.
Twerk Fitness ain't no joke. I will have them ladies in Twerk Fitness with the CKD.
It was
about to go down.
We had the sport collection like pop off, and she did some like female sport stuff, so it was cool.
I'm talking about the sweatbands. I'm talking about the sweat towels. I'm talking about the water bottles. I'm talking about.
That's dope. I like that idea. We're probably gonna.
I'm talking about when ladies go to work and they got, oh, it's in the morning, I need my coffee. They got the CKD or coffee mug in class. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, man, I got one of them, too. My homegirl
made one of them. Don't play with it.
CKD or coffee mug. It's the best.
Don't play with it. I'm trying to throw you some shit now. Catch it.
Take off that box, CKD holster on
there.
Yeah.
I got a question. Yeah. What's the creative process? Because it seems like y'all take a lot of pride in the picture quality.
Yeah.
In the marketing, right? Like how it looks, yeah.
That's a good question. All right, so the first time we ever did Trap Friday, I always thought Flyer was kind of lame and like it didn't make sense to what the event was trying to like say. You would have an event coming up or the club and they have like a girl on there and she not gonna be like Melissa Ford on the
exactly.
Club.
Exactly, I hate when people do that shit. I'm sorry, it got to me. But I hate when people do
that.
Because I'm like, oh, is Rihanna gonna be there?
Exactly.
She on the
You know what I mean? People walk around like, I think Rihanna gonna be there. But so, I remember, so I hit my homie up, his name Mose. He actually does like, he does the graphics for CKDO. Mm-hmm. I hit him up, it was our first time working together. I kinda didn't like what came back, it was just on the text. Mm-hmm. So I had my homegirl she had the grill at the time.
Had the grill going.
I had her take a picture of her mouth and grill and whatever. She sent it back to me with the text over it. So from then on, we just were shooting up like real girls, local girls, and we're just putting them on the flyer. And then it kind of just went from. So the creative process is we kind of try to find like a look that we're trying to go for. Mm-hmm. We get in the studio. I shoot with Lee, this dude named Lee Organized. He went to college with me. And I was shooting with this girl named Minnie too in the beginning. She's pretty fine. She's pretty too. Pretty girl.
She's pretty.
And then that was it, man. We just kind of wanted for it to be real. We wanted to build hype for like the event. So we were just using real life. The girl that you might, because like my homie would say like he from like LA. Anyway, I'm like, you ask him about like a girl named Karushi, like that's just a. The high school with her. It's a regular girl. So I was just taking the regular girls or regular, you know, cool pick and just throwing it up and then putting the text on it and just.
And it took off.
Took off.
And that would have more response than, you know, I got Alexis Sky on the flyer and she's not
exactly.
Even
going to be there.
Alexis Sky ain't nowhere in town.
Never.
She on the fly. Yeah.
Exactly.
I don't like when people do that. It sends the wrong message, like you say.
Yeah. We ain't finna, and then we kind of wanted to put like a lot of work, like we wanted to be creative. We didn't want to just steal a pic from the internet and then put a text over it. We kind of want people, we actually wanted to, the whole process was like to create a magazine cover and also like an accessory to your Instagram page.
That's dope.
Originality. Because yeah, that wasn't done before. Nah, I wouldn't nobody.
You know what I'm saying?
Because yeah. Nobody would think like that.
Because you know, your homie seen you before. You know, you're like, man, damn, I don't really want to. If you critical, I don't really want to post this on my page. But if it's fly, you want to post it.
If it's some fresh shit.
So that was your homie.
Shout out to Dope Shit on it, too. Yeah, yeah.
So that was like, that was like the thing we was doing.
I like it. Good idea.
All the ideas. Free game.
So do we have
free
anything
game.
To look forward? Don't tell us your secrets. But do we have anything that we should be on the lookout for? Anything phenomenal you want to let them know? You know, it's coming. It's up and coming. Just be on the lookout.
Yeah. More sounds by CKDO. Mm-hmm. That would probably be like the music. Mm-hmm. Walt DJing.
Walt DJing. Y'all make sure y'all shout out to Walt, CKDO Walt. If you need a DJ, he's on the scene right now.
Yeah.
Ain't hard too.
And then we got more, we pushing out more content, more experiences. We're going to be providing more experiences. I want to say that's about, like, is that about it? And I got an idea. I'm going to go ahead and say it. I don't know, maybe a party, like the 5 o'clock party or something like that. I thought about that the other day. Mm. On a Saturday or something.
It's that midday flow. You know you gotta go to church morning if you want to.
5 p.m.
They still
gonna
go to church. Some of them gonna go to sleep in the clothes. They went to the club and go to church.
Same outfit after trap Friday. Trap Saturday.
It's a
rain. 5 o'clock party, like, because most people, I kind of want to get out. Like, 5 o'clock around the Saturday, it's gonna cool down. Mm-hmm. You know, it's pull up to the 5 o'clock party.
Say no more.
And then hopefully the ladies' night will be coming. That'll be the name of the next party.
Mm-hmm. Let me know. Look,
if you still
let me find out.
I don't really care. We'll think of something else.
Let me find out.
No. Yeah. I'm gonna make sure.
Ladies night.
That's CKDO ladies exclusive right there. Anybody else doing it? You got a problem. I'm say something about you. Don't do it.
After today.
It's CKDO. If you ain't did it, time's up.
Yeah. All right, well, give us your social media tags again, your personal and your business, so they can separate the two.
Let them know how to reach out to you, man.
Yeah, of course.
You can follow me, Reginald Edwards, II, is the same. So, Reginald Edwards, II, that's my Instagram. And then we got Sounds by CKDO. Mm-hmm. That's where you're going to find the musical, entertainment content. Mm-hmm. Then you just got CKDO, that's the clothes, that's the image, it's the content. It's kind of
the movement right there.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So that's where you can find this. We posted it 24/7.
Okay. And make sure you follow Mass CTV, also 28th and Jefferson Podcast, Dragonfly Jones with two S's.
Of
course, you already follow Candy Coated AP. If you're not, you do that as well.
If you're not following already,
after you follow us, kill yourself.
Yeah, follow us first.
And then kill yourself.
Shout out to Man CTV for keeping it real, having a real one join them today. If you from Nashville, you don't know who they are, look out, it's your boy Rachel. Rachel CKDO, Rachel Evans. This is CKDO, holding it down. What's up? Man CTV.
Appreciate it.